we are running out of time. As a nation, we are committed to limit global warming to below 1.5 degrees. The road is going to be hard, and it's going to be filled with tough choices. Because to reach our climate targets, we have to cut our emissions with 50% by 2030 and with 90% by 2050. So, you've heard this message before? And we're already making progress, you say? Well, the problem is that we're not. We are not on track when it comes to reaching our climate targets. And we are running out of time. Today, the average Norwegian emits 14 tons of CO2 per year. And the reality is that we, all of us, every single one of us, have to cut our emissions with 90% within the next 30 years. That means going from 14 tons to 2 tons. Can we do it? Yes, but we definitely have to make drastic changes in our daily lives. We have to change to a more plant-based diet. We have to recycle and buy used. We have to buy electrical cars and vehicles, use less water, and of course, share more. And if we do all of this, we've estimated that we can cut our emissions in half. 2 tons, it's virtually nothing. So, what does the future look like, keeping in mind 2 tons per person per year? Let me present to you the Montana project in Bergen. Here, the regional utility company BKK teamed up with Sweco to create a sustainable neighborhood in line with the sustainability targets of the Paris Accord. And we call it the 1.5 degree neighborhood. Let's take a look. Buildings are responsible for 40% of the world's and Norway's energy use, and it produces 40% of its emissions. This cannot continue. Buildings have to be a part of the solution. So, do we just tear them down to build up new ones according to the very best standards? No, we have to use what we already have. And when we have to construct new, it has to be more than the sum of its parts. It has to contribute with positives to its surroundings. At Montana, the main building housing the old electrical substation will be kept, reused, and rehabilitated. It will be converted into apartments. And this is great. This helps the project reduce 70% of its emissions. And when they have to build new, they will use timber as the main material, keeping and making sure that emissions are kept low. And by using this approach, I think we will see more unique and more historical buildings being put to new use in the future. And that's exciting. Homes are estimated to contribute with 4 tons per person per year. This is through its materials and energy use. At Montana, we have reduced the energy used considerably by using residual heat from the new subterranean substation. And the key message here is, screen the area, find the local sources. At Montana, we were lucky. The conditions were very good to create and generate energy from solar, geothermal, and water. All the roof surfaces will be used to generate solar power. Travel to and from our homes contributes a lot to the CO2 budget. And day-to-day travels is estimated to be up to 2 to 3 tons. Shared electrical car services. It will persuade homeowners not to own their own vehicles. And other shared services, such as shared tools, shared bicycles, shared scooters and other appliances, it will persuade the homeowners not to own this. And it will result in minimized space needed in the private homes. So, can we do this? And if we do this, are we on the right track? Are we going to reach our climate targets? I think we are definitely on the right pathway, but we have to do more. We have to look at the community as a whole. We have to find synergies and circular solutions. We have to focus on master planning. Because the cities, with the buildings and its infrastructure that we plan and design today, they will be the neighborhoods of the future. Change is a necessity and change is coming. This was a window to the future. And we all have to play a part. Are you with us? Then I'll see you in the 1.5 degree neighborhood in the future. Thank you.